Hello friends, right now I am with Shri B.K. Mishra, the Chairman and Managing Director of Cotton Corporation of India, most commonly referred to as the CCI. This year is going to be a very vital year for the CCI because it is going to play a very significant role in the economy of Indian cotton. The prices of raw cotton are just nearby or below MSP in certain states. And CCI is expected to play a very active role. So, as it is the beginning of the new season 2014-15, the views of Shri Mishra are very important to the cotton industry. Mishra ji, shall we start?
Welcome. Yes, very well.
Very, very good afternoon to you. Mishra ji, what, according to CCI, is the size of Indian crop in the season 2014-15?
This year, we have estimated 402 lakh bales,
okay,
which we reported to CAB, whereas the final estimate done by CAB is 400 lakh bales.
Right.
So in my opinion, I should like to go with the estimate made by CAB.
CAB, okay. So as per the estimates of CCI and CAB combined, that is the Cotton Advisory Board, the quantum of Indian crop for 2014-15 is expected to be in the vicinity of 400 lakh bales, right?
Or 400 lakh bales.
40 million bales. Mr. Ji, what are the major factors that will drive the market in the new season?
This season, in my opinion, rates has to be steady, unlike last 4-5 years, whereas during the season and when arrivals remains to at peak, the prices appeared depressed, whereas as soon as the arrivals becomes slashing down in the next of the months and during lean season, price used to go up, which normally used to be more than 20 to 30%. So this season I am not looking to be that type of price fluctuations. In my opinion, prices to be steady and with the pace of arrival, because whenever it will become at peak level, then right, price need to be, price I expect to be 1000 rupees or 2000 rupees less than the today's price. I am talking about per candy price of the lint cotton.
Right. So that is say for the next quarter?
During the season, as per my opinion, price supposed to be range between 32,000 or to 35,000 rupees per candy.
Okay.
The last level at the peak, in my opinion, it will not go anywhere below 30,000 rupees. It has to be 31,000 to 35,000 rupees per candy.
Okay. So not bottom out below 30,000.
Not at all.
And not, may not go above 35,000.
Above, up to March it will not go. I am talking about
okay,
peak.
Okay.
But subsequently, when season advances, like during lean period, starting from April onwards, it may be 2000 rupees to 3000 rupees pickup, okay, may market take.
Okay, fine. Depending on the demand and supply
situation
in that period. Yes. Right, Mishra ji. What will be the price range of the cotton in the new season? That is your perception. Is it will be bottom out at 30,000, I mean not below 30,000, up to March it will be in the range of 35,000 about?
Up to March we can expect that it should be 34,000-35,000 rupees.
34,000-35,000.
And thereafter, though I can't foresee that it will go beyond 40,000 or so even at the end of the season.
Right. Unlike the last season.
Yes.
Right. So what are the major factors that are driving? I mean, what will decide whether the market will go 37,000 or 30,000?
Normally, as per present demand and supply position,
right,
I think price has to be range bound, and every year increase in the price, if we make out the average of entire year's price, should be 5 to 10% more.
Okay.
Normally, but in last 4-5 years, what happened? I may recall the year 10-11, China, which was having very lean stock, maybe 10-11, 22% or so,
right,
has continuously gone for buying, importing cotton from rest of the world,
right,
which has resulted the hanging over, hanging up of the price, which in my opinion should not be to that extent. I may recall the 10-11 volatility, Because in October 10, I still remember the price started with 28,800 rupees per candy,
right,
which in the month of March and April has gone up to 62,000 rupees per candy.
Right.
And subsequently, in the next 4 months, it has again nosedived to 29,000 rupees.
Right, absolutely.
So this year also, so particularly in this year, I think situation is not that much changed. Because if you compare with the figures, in last, it was the 9-10 season when the total consumption was more than the production. As a result of 10-11, the panic situation was created.
Right.
Subsequently, in 11-12, the gap between the production and consumption was about 3 or 4 million metric tons, 3 million metric tons, subsequently 4.5. So after 12-13, now the gap, because production now is little bit more than the consumption.
Right.
So things should be comfortable all across the board.
Right.
So consumers,
consumer need not worry that much.
Need not worry because, and the surplus word across of 1.25 to 2 million tons is not that much big, which keeps price either very much depressed or which anyway be liable for any hike in the prices. Because 24 million tons about is consumption now, and production is 26 million metric tons.
Right. So
it is less than, as on date, it is less than 10% surplus,
right,
which in case of any agricultural commodity, I think very much necessary, because the certainty of the productivity on account of rains and other things,
right,
it has to take care of that. So in my opinion, word across, though the ending stocks are comparatively more in China.
Right.
Basically, whatever panic situation is being created in all across the world is because of the policy, Chinese policy.
Absolutely. Suddenly because they had changed that time, and now they have changed this
time.
Made
12 million tons stocks with them, and now they have stopped buying. Though recently there is a declaration made by them that by August, till August 2015, they will not liquidate their current stocks.
Okay.
So I think this will anyway, to some extent, ease the situation so far as depression is price is concerned.
Right. So though they may come out and buy cotton, that is what you mean?
No. Cotton, obviously, they have to buy because for their domestic mills, they would like to consume their own cotton first.
Right.
But from rest of the world, they would not come up and buy.
Right.
But even simultaneously, they will not liquidate their cotton. That
okay.
is the, because in last, you remember, you may recall that, or you may be knowing that in April onwards, they, instead of buying from other countries, they consume their own cotton.
Right.
From reserve stocks. From reserve stocks.
Right.
So it has come from 12 to 11 or 10.0 million tons now.
Right.
So that 1.5 million stocks they have liquidated of their own self, which they created in the last 4 or 5 years.
Right.
So as per their policy, they announced that till August 15, they will not liquidate any more of their stocks what they have. But their cotton crop, which is about 7 million or six odd million tons, will certainly go in the hands of farmers.
Farmers, right?
Yes.
So, the most important and the most awaited question of this season is, when is CCI starting full-fledged purchase operations?
No, we have been given the mandate by the government of India that as soon as price touches MSP level, we have to intervene in the market.
Okay.
And presently, as per feedback I got from my persons, there is all central region, Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, Gujarat, everywhere except south part, means Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, prices are above MSP level. So
right.
that's why we are very much in readiness. As soon as prices touches, we will intervene. And Telangana, I think prices are, in my opinion, much more closer to MSP, so we are ready. And as soon as it will touch MSP, we have to intervene.
We have to. So, have you targeted any particular states or any state? If the prices are below MSP, CCI will.
Yes, any state, because as per mandate given to us, we have to intervene wherever within the country price touches MSP level.
Right. And CCI is well equipped right now to do that.
Yes, we have. It is our routine process. Every year, we have to be prepared ourselves for any eventuality of MSP in any of the state.
Right. At any point in the season or any
period of the season. Right. Normally, when price used to remain 5,000 or 5,500 rupees per quintal, then chances of coming it down to 3,700 or 4,000 remains correct. Very bleak. So we know that the price will nowhere be coming down, like happened in 11-12 or like happened in last year 13-14, wherein only few of the distant places we could do MSP for 40,000 bales.
Right.
So, but this season, as we are finding that price may comparatively be
below,
so chances may be there. And I think first of the state may be Telangana.
Okay, fine. So, what is the quantum of purchase that you are looking at? Basically, you have made your survey.
That all, in my opinion, depends on the price.
Right.
As the prices in Telangana are touching MSP, so I think there we have to intervene first.
Okay.
Thereafter, based on the price scenario, which all depends on presently sentiments, and that sentiments too, on the basis of policy, China government adopts.
Right.
Whenever it has to touch MSP level, we have to intervene. But what level price will go and international level? Because international prices affects domestic price much.
Okay.
If like in last 4 or 5 days, on some day it has rose to 200 points even.
Right.
So how it will take a shape? That will affect Indian pricing, which will have a very big impact over the MSP which CCI has to.
Right. So that will impact the rate of seed cotton and which will decide the role of CCI. So any special provisions for purchase, storage and sales this year?
Storage also, normally we used to hire storage as we used to contact ginning and pressing factories. We used to hire storage capacity also. We remain in constant touch with Central Warehousing Corporation, various state warehousing corporations, private warehouses, as well as agricultural marketing committee warehouses.
Right.
So we used to be in touch with them. This year also we have allocated normally 20-25 lakh bales, because under commercial operations also we have to do some procurement for our own benefit and to meet out our overheads.
Right.
So that much as on a standing basis we used to have.
I asked this question in the special context of the market is looking at a short-term steadiness currently. If we follow the ICE technical charts, but in the post-January, it is looking at a very long-term recession. So CCI normal policy is to procure cotton October, November, December, then sales, plan sales, January, February, March. Most of the deliveries happen in April to September period. So procuring now when the market is steady and then selling when the whole world is looking at a recession period.
Whatever I found in the market, whenever prices are going down, everybody is talking about that this status will have to remain for years long.
Right.
But on fundamental basis we go. So this year consumption is improving, whereas production on overall world basis is going down.
Right.
So it is the difference between the two. Difference of the surplus is slashing in last 3 years.
Correct. The ratio is going down.
So in my view, except Chinese policy, 10 million metric ton stock which are held by Chinese government.
Right.
I don't foresee any other fundamental point which will depress the market much.
Okay.
Or which is unlike to previous 2-3 years.
Okay.
Yes, in the year 9-10, consumption was 2.5 or 3 million tons more than production.
Right.
But 10-11 onwards, the production has taken over. 3 million tons, it was more than consumption in 12-13. Whereas you have seen the price in 12-13, it has rose to 49,000 rupees.
Right.
And today, the production is comparatively only 1 million more than the consumption. So what will make the market to go for depression?
Right.
Except Chinese policy.
Correct. Except Chinese policy, there is no valid reason.
I don't foresee any of the reason for going market drastically down than to the level which we have seen in past.
Right. especially in the last 2 months, whatever there was a reaction to the Chinese policy. But like you said, in the long run, the consumers are going to be comfortable with the
exactly. And so far prices. As India is concerned, we are comparatively lesser affected than United States because we are 75% independent.
Right.
Our entire crop, 75% is being consumed
within the country.
And only 25 has to face any hit or face recession of the import prices or any other thing.
Correct.
Whereas in America, the 80% crop, they are very much this volatility prone. Because right. whatever price will improve or go down, it will affect them much on export and import front. Because they are 80% cotton.
Of their crop, they have to export.
Used to there be exported.
No, there is no consumption.
So I think they have much concern over it than the India. Because it will only affect marginal part of our traders and exporters. Right. So far as industry is concerned, 80% consumer will remain happy in my opinion.
Absolutely. A very, very vital point that Mishra ji has made is that India is going to be a much comfortable place to trade in cotton and be a consumer here, because strategically, geographically and in all aspects, India is well placed above any other producing or consuming country, in the sense that if a country like USA is a very large producer of cotton, it does not consume cotton. 80% of its cotton is exported. So any volatility in the cotton prices is going to hit US harder than India. So the competition in exports may be there, but the competition in recession is not there. India is better placed. Similarly, as a consumer, compared to any other consuming country, India is in a better position because it grows what it consumes. So I think, Mishraji, that's a very, very valid point you have made. Now, one last question. Is the system of MSP, the minimum support price, beneficial or detrimental to a country's economy in the long run? In an international seminar, there is a lot of debate. The countries which are growing cotton are more prone to supporting cotton in one way or the other. So is that a healthy thing in the long run, or should it be an open economy like thing everywhere?
You would have noticed that in last 2 years, what MSP we increased? 50 rupees.
Absolutely.
Which is hardly 1% of the minimum support price.
Right.
Last year also 100 rupees, which is 2%.
Right.
So MSP is not intended to help the industry or otherwise. It is only with the view that the farmers, who are the backbone of the Indian economy, because our country is an agricultural country,
right,
so should not be compelled to do distress sale.
Right.
That is basic purpose.
Correct.
So they must get the remunerative price. Whatever cost they used to incur, that cost is necessary to be realized by them. That is the purpose of MSP.
Right.
So in my opinion, under MSP, the focus used to remain always with the farmers. And in case it will not be, and the CCI or Government of India and our agencies like NAFED is also one of the agency will not remain there,
right,
then the next year, suppose today price is 4,000 rupees, they are sure that they will not get support. Under recessionary situations, they will not get 5,000 rupees.
Right.
But they will certainly get at least 4,000 rupees. So what will happen next year, they will not be thinking not to sow cotton.
They will not shy away from
cotton. So what will happen, at least for the industry, next year also cotton will remain available, and it will not be like China, that they have constraint to import 5 million tons cotton in the year 11-12.
Right.
So to avoid, and what benefit who will be getting? US only, which are the biggest importer of cotton, exporter of cotton.
Correct.
So to avoid that situation, because that's why you see in last 8-9 years, Indian cotton consumption, because this policy of MSP has introduced in 1985. Prior to that, India was deficit country. Like China, we have not been dependent on cotton, dependent on consumption of this production of cotton. But subsequently, with the introduction of MSP, we have not only been dependent on production of cotton, but also exporting and having second place.
Right.
As a result, spinning mills also started growing on, and we have one of the biggest spindles after China now.
Right. So, the most important point that we can derive from this conversation is that MSP is not a subsidy.
Not at all.
It is not a subsidy, it is a support system created because basically India is an agri economy, unlike US and China, which do not depend on agriculture so much as their manufacturing and their marketing strengths. So being an agri economy, farmer is a very integral part of the country's system, and especially in textiles, it is the first link of the supply chain. So if the farmer shies away from the produce, that is cotton, and gets into any other crops, then the consumer industry is going to be hit, because India is also the second largest consumer of cotton in the world. So I think you have highlighted the point very well, Mishraji, that supporting the farmer is not like taxing the taxpayer.
Not at all. It is only reserving the farmers concept. As well as reserving the production of the country. Cotton.
Absolutely. It is just safeguarding the...
Safeguarding.
And it only amounts to the basic growing cost of the farmer.
Exactly.
Right. He's not going to earn anything out of the
MSP. Because when market is at the peak, they have received 5,000 rupees also, means 20% more than what they are supposed to get by this MSP.
Absolutely. Then they need not come to the government, or government did not go to them. So, very good thing. Thank you, Mishraji.
Thank you
for your time and sharing your important views with us. Thank you.